Hello dear students, let us start with the new chapter from unit 3rd, section 1. So in unit 3rd, the topic is given against all odds. So what do you think about this? Against all odds. It means against all the difficulties you are facing in your life and you are rising again. Okay, you are not shattered that you are facing so much difficulties in your life and you just overcome all those difficulties. Okay, so you just rise again after facing, after tackling all the difficulties in your life. So that means against all odds. So there is one saying by Francis of Assisi. Assisi is a place in Italy. So he was a saint and he gave one line: start by doing what's necessary, then do what's possible, and suddenly you are doing the impossible. So you should start by doing something necessary, what is important to you. So you just start by doing such kinds of things. Then you should do what is possible. Okay, what possibly you can do. So one, first one is what the basic things you need. Okay, so that you do. Then what is possible with your strength, abilities, what is possible, you do such things. And then suddenly you will realize that you are doing the impossible, the things that you haven't imagined before. So you are doing something impossible. So here in this chapter, I have a lot of sports to play. So we will talk about a wheelchair basketball player. You will think that what is wheelchair basketball? See, you just saw on the TVs, on the sports channels, that people are playing basketball by running on their feet. And now you as ma'am is saying like that, wheelchair basketball, what is this? So wheelchair basketball is also a sport in which the persons who are disabled, who are physically challenged, okay, they have some problems in their legs, so they can't walk like normal person, they sit on the wheelchair and they play the basketball. This is also a national and international level sports. So this story, real talk, okay, this is of Kartiki Patel, who is a wheelchair basketball player. And this story was put up, this article you can say, or the interview was put up in the prestigious newspaper The Hindu in the year 2018. Okay, so from there this is taken. First, you must be familiar with the words disabled and physically challenged. Disabled. But now we don't use the words like disabled for the person who are facing certain difficulties in doing some kinds of things. So we don't use the word disabled. We just use differently able, or we can say physically challenged. So disabled is the most generally accepted term to refer to the people with a permanent illness or injury that makes it difficult for them to use any part of their body completely or easily. So the person to whom we call as disabled, differently abled, or physically challenged, those persons means they are having certain kinds of injury in their body or illness, or some permanent illness in their body that makes it difficult for them to do some work, okay, like a normal human being. So they face difficulty or they do some works in a different manner. So the illness is sometimes a permanent, that is from birth they are having. And sometimes what happens with some certain kinds of accidents or incident in life, okay, in the middle of their life they face this kind of disability that they are unable to live like a normal human. So I'm not saying that they are not normal, they are also normal, they are also the part of the society, but just their doing of work like a normal human being, they just do the work quickly or in a very flexible manner. So they face certain difficulties for doing, but they just with the time they develop such abilities, okay, so that they can do their work. So here is a unit that will make you think about an exceptional group of people in our midst, in our society. From this chapter, you will get to know about the exceptional group of people. I have a lot of sports to play. This is said by Kartiki Patel, as I said earlier, the wheelchair basketball player of India. If you meet with an accident and realize that you won't be able to walk again, would you accept the defeat and give up? Or would you fight back? So, in the starting of this chapter, there is one question. So, you have to introspect, you have to think about it from your self-perception, that if you meet with an accident in your life, okay, and realize that you won't be able to walk again, that there is certain kinds of injury in your leg, so that you will be unable to walk in your life ever again. So would you just accept the defeat? You will think that, oh, that's it, I'm unable to walk, so I'm not going to do anything. So you will have just a negative thought around such situation, or you will be optimistic to have the positive side, okay, or you would fight back, okay, you come back, you rise again. That's okay, I have got this injury, but my life will not stop here, okay, I will develop certain I can develop new way to live my life as perfectly as it was earlier. Okay, so there is a viewpoint, okay, that is negative and positive. So in what manner you will think, that is up to you. So here, read this inspiring passage on a young woman with true grit. Almost 10 years ago, Kartiki Patel woke up in a hospital bed and couldn't feel her legs. So what happened almost 10 years ago that Kartiki Patel, she woke up in a hospital bed and she was unable to feel the sensation in her legs, but she was relieved though that they were still there. Okay, she can't feel, she was unable to feel the legs, that it is there, but she was relieved after seeing that, yes, it is there, my legs are there. Okay, but she was not feeling any kind of sensation in that. She had been on a road trip with her cousins to Gujarat when at a turning The car went off the road, down an 8-foot drop and somersaulted. So what happened? Why she woke up in a hospital bed? Because she went on a road trip. She had been on a road trip with her cousins, okay, to Gujarat. And when by turning the car on the car went off the road. And it dropped down 8 foot. Okay, and somersaulted means the car rolled right over. Okay, and it went on 8 foot down. So that was a major accident. Okay, I was sitting in the back and my feet got badly hurt. So she, while on the road trip, she was sitting at the back. Okay, and in this accident, what happened? Her feet got badly hurt. So she thought that amputation was the worst that could happen at that point. So at that point of time, when she got badly hurt in her legs, she thought that amputation means cutting off her leg was the only option she is having at that time. That was the worst kind of feeling she had at that point of time. So, but when after waking up in the hospital bed and she thought that her legs and she was unable to feel her legs, but she was relieved after seeing that her legs are still there. So she thought that I could exercise and get back on my feet, and that's what people kept me telling. So she thought that with the little exercise she can get better and she can start walking on her feet again. And also the people nearby her, okay, they also suggested the same thing. So you do certain kinds of exercises and you will be back on your feet again. But when I finally asked the doctor, he said, did nobody tell you that you are never going to walk again? So doctor, clearly he said that, did nobody tell you that you are never ever going to walk again? So Kartiki explained in a conversational tone that his spine had been broken and this spinal cord severed. So she told in that interview that what all things happened to her, her spine, the spinal cords got severely broken into pieces, okay, two pieces. That was a big blow. I lost heart for some time. I lost heart means I lost all hope for some time. Kartiki had always been enthusiastic about sports. Enthusiastic means the person who is very interested or extremely interested in certain kinds of activity. So she was very interested. She had always been very much interested in all the sports activities, playing basketball in college in Mumbai, even bunking lectures to put in more than 8 hours of practice every day. So she used to leave her classes to bunk her classes, lectures, okay, and she used to devote more time in her practice for the basketball. Even when she lost her parents, her mother died when she was in standard 12 or class 12. Okay, so even after losing her parents, her mother died when she was in standard 12 and her father died when she was in her final undergraduate year. So she kept playing. Actually, she was trying to cope with the situation. Okay, so she used to devote her time in playing so that she won't be able to get some free time to think about all such losses of parents. So with all the time I had and with no one to tell me to study, to do things, okay, there was no one for her to tell her to focus on studies or do certain kinds of things. So she just used her time in practicing basketball. So after finishing college and post-graduation, she got a job, IT-related back office work. So all these things were before the accident. Okay, before the accident, she completed her college, post-graduation, and she got a IT-related back office work. A year later, the accident happened and she was 25 years old. So after the accident, a senior colleague means the person who used to work with you, okay, in the same department, who used to work with you. So the senior colleague who lived with multiple sclerosis means it is a kind of disease with the after some period of time the person will lose the feeling and the loss of control of movements and speech in his body. So the senior colleague who was going through such disease like multiple sclerosis, he pushed her to return to work. Okay, he gave some positivity to her and pushed her to get back to work after the accident also. So 4 months later, she returned to her work. It took my mind off a lot of negative thoughts that kept coming into my head when I lay in bed. So after the accident, when she lost her legs, okay, so while just laying in the beds for all the times, okay, many negative thoughts just used to come in her mind. So sports was far from her mind at the time, but a few years into the job, she was getting bored. So after the accident, she was unable to think about the sports as she lost her legs. But after getting into the job and working the same kind of job every day, she was getting bored in her office job. So I was happy to be earning and be on my feet again. Okay, she was happy to be earning and leading the life by herself and taking care of herself. But I was doing the same thing every day. She was just doing the same kind of thing every day. So she was getting bored. An uncle had suggested she take up swimming and she now took him up on it. So an uncle of hers suggested that she can take into swimming, and she did that. Once she picked it up, her competitive streak means the feeling that you try very hard, means a certain competitiveness feeling in you. So try very hard to do better than others. So while doing the swimming, she picked, after the practice, she picked up her competitive spirit streak, took over, and she entered competition, and she started taking parts in the competitions, and she won several medals in that. So it was at a swimming meet. So once, what happened at a swimming meet, that Kartiki met the chairperson of Wheelchair Basketball Federation of India, WBFI. So she met with the chairperson of the Wheelchair Basketball Federation of India, who told her about a national championship in Chennai. So Kartiki landed up there but found that there were no women basketball players yet. So in that competition of swimming, she met that chairperson and he told her about the national championship of basketball in Chennai, and she went there. And after going there, she found that there were no any female basketball player. So fortunately, a group of army veterans means the person of the army who are now retired. So the group of army veterans from Pune encouraged her to take her love for sports further. They gave her hope and positivity to take her sports further. and she started to play wheelchair badminton. So she started to play their wheelchair badminton. Soon she won the national 3 years in a row and represented India in para tournaments abroad, even winning a bronze medal in a Spanish Open. So you can see now, during her college time, she used to play basketball. She used to practice that. And then after the accident, she took swimming and she won medals there. And then also wheelchair badminton also she took now. So meanwhile, WBFI means Wheelchair Basketball Federation of India was just beginning to get more women on court, and an Indian team was forming. So now they started taking other women also and started to form an Indian team of wheelchair basketball players. So I took up basketball again. So again she took up basketball and started playing, and that was in the year 2017. Karthiki says that wheelchair basketball is tougher than playing the game on your feet. And yes, it is very true. So while you play the normal basketball, you use your legs and hands both. Okay. And while in the wheelchair, you have to manage the wheelchair also with your hands. And then you have to manage the ball also. So Karthiki says that wheelchair basketball is tougher than playing the game on your feet. You have to control the ball with your hands and also move the wheelchair with your hands. A year later, getting the chair to do her bidding on court is still work in progress. Getting the chair to move the way she wanted is still in progress. She was practicing that. So I can shoot from close. She can throw the ball from close, but not yet even from the free throw line. When you are standing, okay, now she is comparing the wheelchair basketball with the normal players who play the basketball. Okay, when you are standing, it all come from your knees, right? So all the strength just come from your knees, and in the wheelchair it has to come from your waist, okay, from the waistline. And in her, that fitness is not there yet. I need to develop a stronger back and abs. Abs means the muscles of the abdomen. So she has to develop the stronger back and abs for playing wheelchair basketball. So she quits her job in the year 2015 and registered for a master's degree in social entrepreneurship. So for the social entrepreneurship, she registered for her. And social entrepreneurs means the persons who build their business around solving the social problems. They think of helping the community is equally important as doing the business and making profit. So she registered for the master degree. She is also testing a new business idea, adaptive fitness classes for paraplegics. She has also finished her first set of scuba lessons. Scuba diving means swimming underwater using special equipments for the breathing. So she also finished her first set of scuba with just the open water dives to be done before she get her certification. Then there is cycling. She bought herself a tricycle, bicycle two wheels, tricycle three. Okay, so she bought herself a tricycle with the intention of joining a Manali Kardungla ride. So she wanted to do a ride also with her tricycle, and she bought that with other people's with disabilities, but says, I don't think I can do it right away. And she also said that after buying the cycle and all, she wanted to do that right, but she said that I don't think I can do it right away. I'm thinking of doing a 100-kilometer ride first. So in December 2017, Kartiki got married. Okay, so she got married in the year 2017 and in the month December. Kartiki got married. I met Harman when I first joined work. Okay, so she met this boy Harman when she first joined her work. After my accident, he took care of me and was always with me. That's when it all started. So Harman, they met on the work, okay, and after the accident also he took care of her and always remained beside her. She insisted that she isn't good enough with words to describe the relationship or Harman. So in that interview she said that she is not good enough with her words so that she can describe her relationship with Harman and the boy Harman also in a very perfect manner. But her blood tone means the voice that does not show any kind of emotion. So with her blood tone belies the hint of a smile that sits around her lips and broadens until it splits her face. So she was saying all these things that I can't describe with my words, okay, in a very bland or normal tone. But her smile on the face, it shows that how much happy she is, okay. Now the interviewer asked, what next? Any plans to start a family? So she said that I would love to. Maybe when we are little more settled, okay, she and Harman are little more settled, so at that point of time they can think of starting a family. Till then I have a lot of sports to play. So she said that till she start a family, I have a lot of sports to play. I haven't written them down. I should write them and tick them off one by one. So now she said that I haven't written all the sports that I wanted to do, but now I will write and tick one by one all after I do it. The next checkbox is ready. And she also said about her next list, what she has to do. Okay, the next checkbox is ready in early February 2018. She was selected captain of India's women's basketball team for the Asian Para Games qualifiers in Bangkok in March. And what's next? The 2020 Paralympics, I plan to go. So she planned to go in the 2020 Paralympics. Even if I don't get to participate, I am taking it one tournament at a time. This was all about Kartiki Patel. Even after getting into such a major accident, okay, she did not lose her hope. She fought back. She rose among all. So that is the good spirit. She has a cheerfulness, a positivity, a confidence, hopefulness, positive vibes. Okay, all these words describe Kartiki Patel. She is not shattered by her sudden disability after the accident, but she took it in a very positive manner, okay, and she is doing all such activities what we generally don't think to do. But even after getting into such major accident, she did not lose her hope, and she is into such activities which we just can't imagine that. I don't play basketball or a badminton, but see, such an inspiring story, na? Okay, dear. That's all from my side. Thank you.